So before we starting this session, and especially for the smooth conduction of this training and smooth conduction of this session, you all have to follow some instruction. So first of all, kindly keep your mic on mute condition unless and until it is required to unmute. And the second thing, don't ask any question in between of my discussion. Whatever your doubts and questions are, just put in the chat box. If I feel it is important to answer at that time, I will definitely try to answer. Otherwise, whatever your doubts and question, you can ask at the end of the session. And kindly write your name and contact number in the chat box so that later we can contact with you. Whatever during the session, if I ask any question, so like yes, no type of question, you have to answer instantly. You all have a right to answer that question. Is that all clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So first of all, I would like to introduce myself, Ziaur Rahman Ansari, and I have done Bachelor in Civil Engineering, Master in Structural Engineering, and have work experience of almost all the sectors. And since last few years, I am working as an independent design consultant and software trainer. And as per my expectation, you all attenders want to become a structural engineer, okay, and many of you are pursuing your bachelor's, many of you are pursuing your master's, some of you may also pursuing your doctorate, and some of you may be working on site as a site engineer. So most of you are interested to want to become a structural engineer. So first of all, we need to understand what are the things you need to get to become a good structural engineer. So first of all, we are trying to clarify this point. So basically there are four points that will make you a good structural engineer. What are those? So these four points, and over these four points you have to get the command. As I told you, many of you are pursuing your bachelor's and master's, and some of you are means a site engineer, want to change your career from site engineer to the design engineer. So when you are going to face any interview, so what interviewer will ask, what industry demand? Okay, so the current scenario is what, when you are going to look into the industry, they will ask about the first question, how many softwares you are knowing? How many softwares you are knowing? So the very first thing. So you need to look into the market. What softwares are there? So too many softwares are there. Too many softwares are there. So basically thing is what, you need to focus which softwares are in demand. Which software is means actually used by the most of the consultancies, most of the structural designers are using which softwares. And you are as per your need, either you want to design the residential structure or building structures or industrial structure, or you want to design the bridges. So accordingly, you need to learn the softwares. So many softwares are there. And next question is what? Okay, so very first thing is what, you need to have the command over the softwares. You need to good command over the softwares. Next to that, what you need to have the basic concept about the structural engineering, about the structure concepts. What it means, if your structure is subjected to different kinds of the loads, suppose your structure is subjected to only gravity load, so how, what would be the behavior under the application of the loading? If your structure is subjected to the gravity load, if your structure is subjected to lateral load, so what will the behavior of your structure? So under the different kinds of the loading, what will be the structural behavior? What will be the bending moment diagram of different types of the beam? What will be the shear force diagram? What material you should use for the different structural element? If I am going to deal high-rise structure, for an example, so is it okay? Is it economical if I am going to use the grade for entire structure, same grade for the entire structure? No, there is some concept with which you can change your grade of concrete for different structural elements. Like for the columns and shear wall, you can use higher grade of concrete. for the other structural element like beam and slab, where you can reduce the grade of concrete. So these are the basic concepts. Some mathematical, some calculation you should be able to do. So these are basic structural knowledge, and these things you will get from your academics. Then having the knowledge of structural design software, for example, suppose you are getting the good command over the software. Suppose you are having the good knowledge of structural behavior, the structural concept. So will it be sufficient to design the structure? Yes, tell me answer. Will it be sufficient to design the structure?
No, sir.
Yes, you can design the structure. You can design the structure, but the problem is what? Your design structure will be uneconomical as well as unstable. Your structure will be uneconomical as well as unstable. Why? Because if you are not going to follow the design code, your design code will provide the guidelines. If you are going to follow the guidelines as suggested by the standard design codes, so your structure will be economical as well as stable. It is similar to that of the traffic guidelines. For example, suppose you are moving over the road, and if you are not going to follow the traffic guidelines, so what will happen? You are going to harm to yourself as well as to others. That will be danger. The same thing is actually applicable in the structural design field. If you are having the knowledge of softwares, if you are having the knowledge of basic knowledge of the structural design, you can design the structure. But if you are not going to follow the design code, so what will happen? You are going to make your structure as danger. Your structure may get collapse, and all the people living inside of the structure may be in danger. They may also lose their life. If you are not going to follow the guidelines and limitation and instructions suggested by the code. So this is a very important thing. You need to understand what are their important codes. Like IS-456 code is there for the basic design of RCC structure. IS-800-2007 is there for the design of steel structure. If you want to know how much load you have to apply over your structure, whatever the type of structure is there, like residential, commercial, industrial, whatever the type of structure is there, if you want to calculate the load over that structure, so what code you have to follow? So 875 part 1, part 2, part 3 is there. If you want to assign the lateral load, earthquake load to your structure, so what code is there? So that is IS-1893-2016. If you want to perform the ductile detailing, when to perform the ductile detailing, when not to perform the ductile detailing, up to what height you have to assign the earthquake load. So who will tell you all these things? Who will tell you? Definitely standard code will tell you about all these things. Your all question will be resolved by this guideline suggested by the IS codes. So many IS codes are there. So you should have the knowledge about all these codes and its clauses. Without the knowledge of IS codes, definitely your structure will be unstable and uneconomical. Now, what next thing is important? Okay, I have a good command over the structural design softwares. I have a good concept of structural design, and also I have a good knowledge and a good study of IS codes. So will it be sufficient to get the job? If I'm looking the job and I'm going to face any interview, so what they will ask? Yeah, I am having the good knowledge of the structural design softwares, good knowledge of structural design concepts, having the knowledge of IS codes. Even though I'm not getting this job, why? When I'm going to face the interview, they will ask me, what is your experience? And experience, not the meaning of spending the time, 1 year, 2 year. They are expecting that how many real life projects you have done. Am I right or wrong? Hello?
Yes, sir. What you are saying?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Actually, they are asking about how many real life projects you have completed. Because, in most of the training center, in most of the training, what you will do, like dummy projects will be there, like simple columns, simple beams, and simple geometry of this structure will be there, and there you will do like analysis and design, and that's it. But if you are going to face a real example, real life project, So real challenges you need to deal. And dealing that real challenges is nothing but the experience. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so real life projects. So all these things, the first, second, third and fourth, these all four pillars will actually make you professional structural engineer. So by just keeping all these things in mind and by keeping all the things to fill the gap between the academics, curriculum and design industry requirement, to bridge this gap, we have prepared this training program. In this training program, we have covered all those things. Here we are going to take this complete training is going to be done in three sections. In the first section, what we will do, we are going to cover all the basic commands, all the basic commands, all the advanced commands in very detailed way. In a very detailed way, then validation of the software will also be there. ETAP software, validation of ETAP software will be there. Validation means what? If software is just a software, if I am giving the wrong input, so definitely I will get the wrong output. If I am giving the right output input, so I will get the wrong right output. So whatever you are going to put in the software, accordingly the software will give the answer. So if suppose I am giving the right input, so what I should get? Hello? What I should get if I am giving the right input? Hello?
You will get right output.
Yes, I should get the right output. But what is the validation? Hello? Whether the software is giving the right output or not? So that we will do in this software. Without of validating the software, how you can use? Because we are going to deal with the real, with the life of the people. Okay, so if you are going to do design your structure which may lead to be the failure, so that is very dangerous. You will not become a good structural engineer. So first, so that is also included in this training program, validation of the software. Then in the first section, we are going to take a dummy project. We will take there we will discuss all the advanced modeling options. What does mean the model? What does mean the modeling? What is the importance of modeling? We will discuss after some time. But here it is what? Modeling will be there. Because your architecture plan will always be different. Analysis will be same for every project. Design will be same for the every project. Modeling will, analysis, scheduling, detailing, these all things will be same for all the project. What difference will be there? Only the architecture plan. Your architecture plan, my architecture plan will be different. So always your model will be different. Your modeling work will be different. Later on, all the stages will be same. So that's why we are focusing most of in the first section deeply in the modeling. So overall, the objective of the first section of this training will be what? The participant should become familiar with the software first. Should get the confidence of using the software. Thereafter, we are going to move for the real life project. Thereafter, we are going to deal the real life project. In the real life project, we are going to follow these steps. And this step is nothing but the step followed by this. Most of the practicing structural engineer, most of the design consultancies are going to complete the project along these all eight steps. So in the first step is what? If you are going to work as a structural engineer, so you will get the architectural drawing from the architect. This is the first step. So what kind of architectural drawing you will get? And you should be able to study that architectural drawing. So what things like, see, this kind of architectural drawing will come to you first. If you are going to work as a structural engineer, is it visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this kind of architectural drawing will come to you first. This is a residential building. This one is the residential building. This is what? This is a public building. This is a hostel building. This is another kind of residential building. This is what? This is a hostel building. Okay. So this kind of architectural drawing will come to you. So what things you should have a knowledge how to read this architectural drawing. Without of understanding of architectural drawing, you will not be able to prepare your model. Can anyone tell me what does mean by the model? What is the definition of model? Can anyone tell me? Okay, the model is nothing but is a prototype that is going to represent your actual structure. Model is what? That is representing your actual structure. Hello, am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So basically, if you are not getting the actual structure, the concept of the actual structure, the mind of architecture, through the architectural drawing, you will not be able to create the real real model, actual model, that the model that is representing your actual structure. So preparation of the model is very, very important thing, because later stages, later steps are and correct later steps are depends on the model correctness. If you are going to prepare your model as correct, so later stages, later steps will be correct. Like your analysis will be right, your design will be right, your schedule and detail, everything will be right if your model is right. And if you are going to make the mistake in preparing the model, all the later stages will be wrong. Your analysis will be wrong, your design will be wrong, your scheduling, detailing, everything will be wrong if your model is wrong. So you can imagine how much it is important to understand the architectural drawing. Now, after the understanding of architectural drawing, the next step is what? You had to prepare the structural framing plan. The structural engineers, what the next step they are following? They are going to prepare the structural framing plan, or we can say beam layout. So this kind of structural framing plan you have to prepare. So what does mean by the structural framing plan? What will be the present in structural framing plan? And how to read the architectural drawing? That all things we are discussing in a very detail in our complete training program. Then while preparing the structural framing plan, or after getting the architectural drawing, the first responsibility of the structural engineer is what? To decide the positions of the column, positions of the shear wall. So there are the detailed concept, detailed guidelines are there to decide the positions of the column, to decide the orientation of the column, to decide the plenary section sizes of the columns, beams and everything. So proper guidelines are there we are following in our training in detail. If your building is up to G plus 3, if your building is more than of G plus 3 building, if your building is more than of like 10 floor, 20 floor, if the building is high rise structure, so how you will decide the plenary section sizes, that we are discussing in detail. How you will decide the positions of the column, the proper guidelines are there. We are discussing these guidelines for the positioning of the column. How you can decide the orientation of the column, this is a very interesting topic. How you can decide the orientation of the column. So orientation of the column we are discussing. So overall, after having the knowledge of all these things, we have to prepare the structural framing plan like this. After completion of the structural framing plan, the next step is what? You have to prepare the center line plan. You have to prepare the center line plan. So basically what? After having the structural framing plan, your work is over with CAD. Your work is over with the architectural plan. Now your work is going to be start with the ATAPS. If you are going to design your structure with the ATAPS software, so your work is going to be start with the ATAPS after completion of the structural framing plan. So when I'm looking to the ATAPS software, so lot of, see, this kind of model you have to prepare. This is a high-rise structure. This is a high-rise structure. But this is the output. But before of that, while preparing the model, you have to first prepare the grid lines. What does it mean the grid line? This is what? Just give the outline of your model. Outline of your model. And having this, after having this grid line, your modeling will become easy. Your modeling. So what are the different methods of preparing these grid lines in the ATAP software? So basically there are three options. Basically, there are three options. What are those? First one is the offset point method. First one is what? Offset point method. How you can prepare the grid line. Second one is by default grid system method. And third one is the export import method. So if your architectural drawing is simple, in that situation, what we are doing? We are preparing the grid lines in the CAD itself. And by the reference of these grid lines, we are going to prepare the grid lines in the software directly. But if your architectural drawing is very complicated, if your architectural drawing is very complicated, so it is very difficult to prepare the grid lines for this kind of structure in the ETAP software itself. So in that situation, what we are doing, we are exporting this drawing by making the center line plan like this, by making the center line plan. So many of the beginners, they don't know how to prepare this center line plan. How to prepare this center line plan and what assumptions and what consideration we need to take while preparing this center line plan and how effectively you can prepare this center line plan. So your architecture plan or your structural framing plan, if it is complicated, so you can prepare the center line plan, and instead of preparing the grids here, you can directly import the center line in the software like this. Directly you can import entire model. Is that all clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So these all things, yes, in a very detail, yes, we are trying to cover everything to make you a professional structural engineer. So see, this will be done. Later, what next step you have to follow, you have to start the modeling. But before of starting the modeling, see, many steps are there like modeling, analysis, design, scheduling and detailing. But remember, very important point I'm going to quote here, like for every step, like suppose if you are talking about the modeling, so for especially modeling, before of that one step will be there and after of that one step will be there. What those steps are? Before the modeling, some settings will be there, and after the modeling, some checks will be there. Yeah, before the modeling,
yes,
some,
sir,
settings will be there, and after the modeling, some checks will be there. What it means, you also, before the analysis, some settings will be there, after the analysis, some checks will be there. Before the design, some settings will be there, after the design, some checks will be there. What it means, before of execution of any step, like modeling, if I'm talking, modeling, so before of that, some settings like how to material property definitions, load definitions, load combination definitions, that all things. Then you have to perform the analysis, you have to perform the modeling, you have to prepare your model, and after that, you have to check your model. Whether your model is right or wrong, some checks, some assurity should be there or not. Blindly, we can't move to the next step. So after the modeling, you have to check whether your step is right or wrong. Then you have to move to the analysis. If your model is correct, so beginners many times doing the mistake of preparing the model. So when you complete your model, you need to check your model. And if you are getting the errors, so it is very important skill to reduce the error. How to overcome that errors to make your model as perfect. Then we move to the analysis. Okay, then before the analysis, some settings will be there. After the analysis, analysis check will be there. Likewise, we have to proceed. Is that all clear? Hello? Then some conceptual studies, yes, sir, will, yes, also, sir, be there. Like suppose in the you have to define what material properties before the modeling. You have to define the section properties. Suppose I am going to define the slab. So most of the time, students are confused. Most of the times, what students are confused when to define the membrane element, when to define the shell element, what is the difference between the membrane element, what is the difference between membrane and shell element, when to use the layered element. So these all things, conceptual studies will also be there in detail. Okay, so finally what, after all this definition, we will learn what are the different methods of modeling of columns. What are the different methods of modeling of column? How to model your column? So basic way, advanced way, smart way. How smartly you can model your column in a within 30 seconds, in a within 1 minute, based on the structure. So what are the different smart way of modeling of column? What are the different smart way of modeling of beam? What are the different smart way of modeling of floors or slabs? What are the different smart way of modeling of staircase? That all things we will learn in detail. Thereafter, after completion of the model, then how to calculate the load over the structure, how to assign the loads. So many things will be there to discuss. lot of things due to time constraint. I'm not able to discuss all these things here. So after application of all the loads, what we have to proceed for the analysis? Okay, so this kind of model will be ready. Like this, your model will be ready. See, this kind of model. So after completion of the modeling, we are going to proceed for the analysis. Okay. Go to plan at any level. So analysis you have to done like this. And once the analysis gets done, it will show you what analysis result. So you should have the knowledge how to read the analysis result. It is not like that directly you can move to the design. After the completion of the analysis, you should be able to see, you should be able to check how much bending moment is coming to the beam, how much shear force is coming to the particular beam. So how to look that? See, most of the time, working professionals and some of the students, that they know you have to look the moment along 3-3. But what is the reason why we are looking the moment along 3-3? Why we are looking the moment along 2-2? So it is very important to understand that we are discussing. Then how to define the load combination? So if your structure is only subjected to gravitational load, so how many number of load combination will be there? So only two load combination will be there, like service and factor load combination. But if your structure is subjected to like earthquake load also, wind load also, or all other different kinds of the loads, so how many load combinations will be there? And how to prepare that load combination in the ETAP software? What does mean by the load envelope? So that is the very brief discussion we are covering. So if you are dealing high-rise structure, so about 50 to 100 load combination you need to define. This kind of steps and load combinations we are having. So whatever the materials I am showing here, that all we are sharing with you during the training. And that will be shared with you, and it will be available with you long life. It will be available with you long life. Okay. So after that, after the analysis gets completed, and many things are there to check. Okay. So that you should have a knowledge. Like if the fixed beam is there, like suppose this kind of fixed beam is there. So what will the bending moment diagram of fixed beam? Bending moment diagram of simply supported beam? What will be the bending moment diagram if the beam is cantilever? So this basic knowledge you should have so that you can understand the analyzed result, analyzed output, and you can check whether your analysis is right or wrong also. It is very important. One point is there. Actually, time is not allowing to me discuss because your model correctness, you can also judge and you can also check by the analysis result also. Hello. You can check your model, whether it is right or wrong. You can check it after the analysis result also. Okay. It's very, very important. So that's why I'm not going to discuss here. Okay. So after completion of all these analysis, what will be the lateral deformation? What will be the gravitational directional deformation? What will be the deflection of the beam? What is the limit of the deflection of the beam? Okay. Whether it is within the limit or not. So these all checks we have to perform after the completion of the analysis. First thing. Second thing, after the completion of analysis, you have to check whether your analysis is right or wrong. Whether all the considered load has been transferred to the all the structure element or not. Very important. For an example, while doing the modeling, suppose column is there like this, and by mistake, you have not correctly placed beam over the column. There is a problem. Your beam is not connected with your column. So tell me, the load will transfer or not? Hello?
Not transferring loads.
It is not going to transfer. But while checking the model, ETAPS will show, sometimes ETAPS is not able to catch that kind of error. Hello? What I am saying? ETAPS, I told you, software is just a, hello?
Yes, sir.
Software is just a software. Okay. You have to validate the result. So sometime what will happen, you are having the column like this and your beam is not connected with the column. So in that situation, if I am going to check my model, so ETAP will show you there is no modeling error. There is no modeling error. But is there modeling error or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
There is a modeling error. Yeah, software is not capable to catch this modeling error. So how you will check it? So this will be this will be presented by the analysis result. But you should have a knowledge how to find out that, how to catch that error. So very interesting topic is this. After the analysis, how to correct the model, very interesting topic. So I will this kind of level we are trying to maintain in our training program. And next, how you can check, go to analyze, check last analysis run log. So this data will show you whether all the load has been transferred or not. So how to read this output that we are trying to cover. Okay, so this is all the things after the analysis. These are the checks. Later on, we are moving for the design. So before of the designing, you have to do many settings. Okay, then you can proceed for the design. So I'm not going to discuss all those things here. Just click over the design. So your structure will undergo to the design, and after some time, the result will be appearing here. So after the design, you have to check whether all the member pass the design check or not. Is there any member which is failing in the design? Okay, I'm asking to all of you one question. Just tell me if one column is looking to be failed. If one column, for example, this column is looking out to be failed, it is represented by the red color. So what would be the solution to make this column to be passed? Hello? Tell me fast.
Replace and change the dimension.
Replacing and changing of the dimension. Okay, one solution. Another solution, tell me fast. Yeah, I'm asking to all of you. Give me answer.
Increasing the cross section, sir.
Increasing the cross section. Anyone else? Yes, Seth.
Grade also change.
Okay, one other option. Either you can change the section size and grade. You all are, means I can say directly, sorry, you all are wrong. Actually, first thing you need to look, what is the reason of failure? Hello? Have you checked that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then
yes,
how
sir.
You can say that? How you can say that just increase the section, just increase the grade? How you can say that? Without of knowing the reason of the failure, how you can say increase the section size? So increasing of the section size, that not only the solution, that's a very later stage of thinking about the increasing the section size. So you should understand whether it is failing the shear, whether it is failing the flexure, and what is the reason of failure. Okay, so that we are trying to cover in this training program in detail. This is the one point I'm taking. So likewise, many points are there. Okay, what does it mean by these values you are getting over the beams? So these are the reinforcement. These are the reinforcement requirement. This is the requirement of the reinforcement over the beam. So at many location, you are looking over, like you are able to see 180, 180, 180. So why it is showing 180? So it is representing minimum reinforcement required for that particular beam location or for that particular beam. So what codal requirement? So here we, at every point, we are going to validate the result or validate the output of the ETAP software with our standard code. So what the code says, that how much minimum percentage of reinforcement should be present in your beam, let me show you. The code says that the minimum percentage of reinforcement.
Screen sharing is not full, sir.
Sorry?
Sir, screen sharing is not full on my side.
So that's, I think it is the problem from your side. Hello?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, look at this. Yeah, what is the minimum percentage of reinforcement? So it is 0.85 B into D, if I'm going to modify this formula. So what is the formula? Minimum reinforcement in the beam should be is equal to 0.85 multiplied by B into effective depth divided by FY, strength of your material, steel material. Okay. So what it will be? Tell me. So you need to look your ETAP software, whether your ETAP software is giving the correct result or not. Hello, would you like to check this or not? Hello. So
yes,
area of steel will be equal to 0.85 multiplied by width of this beam is actually 230 and size of the this beam I need to look. So just right click over the member and 230 by 500 section size there and effective cover for this beam is 40. So how much it effective depth will become? Effective depth will become 460. Am I right or wrong? Hello?
Right, sir.
So effective depth will become 460. So put here is 460. Divide this all value by grade of steel here. I have used every 500. Just divide and find out the answer. Tell me what value you are getting.
179.8.
Yes, very good. 179.8 something. So can I say it is approximately equal to 180? Hello?
Yes, sir. 180.
So whether your software is 100% following the design code or not? We are going to validate the result of the ETAP software and we are going to relate it with the CODEL requirement and CODEL suggestion. Okay, so this is very important. Dealing with the dummy project is not the solution. That will not make you comfort and make you able to get the job in the industry, in the design consultancy. Most of the times people, when they are going to face the interview, this kind of questions they will ask. And you, participants and students are failing to answer. Okay, so it's all done. So after the completion of the analysis, design design with the software. Next, we have to prepare the schedule. Can anyone tell me what does mean by the schedule? Hello? Tell me fast. What does mean by the schedule? Yes. So scheduling is nothing but the summary of your design. Hello? What? Scheduling and detailing is nothing but the summary of your design. Suppose we are the engineers and after the design, we know that this section size, this much percentage of reinforcement, this much number of reinforcement bars are okay for this column. So can we send this model directly on site for the site execution? No, definitely no. So we have to give the summary of the design result. And preparation of that summary of the design result is nothing but the schedule. So we are preparing the schedule of this result, this design in this format. And in this training program, we are trying to cover this in detail. Each and every member, we are trying to make you prepare the schedule for each member, like for beams. So how to prepare the schedule of beam, how to prepare the schedule of column manually. Okay, manually first we are trying to teach. And then how to prepare the detail of the beams, okay, in the light of the requirement made by the SP34. The SP34, the code, is Indian standard for the scheduling and detailing of the structural element. Like beam, column, footing, everything. Okay. So in the light of the CODEL requirement of SP34, we are trying to cover the schedule and detail of each individual structural element. And as per the design output of the code, as per the design output of the ETAP software, we are going to prepare the schedule of beam, we are going to prepare the schedule of column, prepare the schedule of slab. And along with the designing of the structure with the ETAP software, we are going to use excellent Excel sheets for the design of the slabs, because in the software, we are not going to design the slab. So we are going to use Excel sheets. So we have excellent Excel sheet for the designing of the two-way slab, one-way slab, staircase. Okay, many things are there. Let me show you. Like for the designing of staircase. So we are going to use this Excel sheet for the design of staircase. By just giving the basic input, the software Excel sheet will give you a schedule and summary of the design as well as detail of the design. This kind of Excel sheets we are having. And this all Excel sheet we will share with you. And this will be available with you long life. Then after that, your design will be completed. Your schedule and detail will be completed. So finally, we have to prepare the sheet. This sheet we have to send on site for the site execution. This is what, like this. The details, center line plan of your column, footing, everything we have to prepare. And this we will share on send on site. So accordingly, the laborers and site engineers will execute the project, will complete the project. So this is what manually. But if you are going to prepare the schedule and detail manually every time for every project, so it will take hell lot of time. It will take a hell lot of time. So to overcome this problem of time consumption and to complete the project within a short period of time and to reduce the time of scheduling and detailing, a very excellent software in market is there, which is in very, very in large demand. Most of the independent consultants, most of the design consultancies nowadays are using the software whose name is what? Can anyone guess? Hello?
RCDC.
Yes. Exactly. RCDC. So that is what RCDC. So by looking into the industry and demand in the industry and to make you ready for the industry, we have also included RCDC software in this training program. So we are trying to cover how to use this RCDC software. So very brief discussion will be there for the designing of RCDC software, for the designing of beam, scheduling of the beam, detailing of the beam, designing of the column, scheduling of the column, everything we are going to cover with this software. Slabs. Okay. Everything we will cover in detail. Now again, the same question will come into the picture. Whether your ETAPS result, most of the time students are asking, sir, my result is not matching. My ETAPS result is not matching with the RCDC result. Are you facing this kind of problem or not? Hello.
Yes, sir.
So that is again one kind of validation we are going to cover. Behind every step, behind every action, we are trying to give you the concept. And that concept will make you confident structural engineer, professional structural engineer. So we are going to show you your manual result with the software result, your software comparison with output of the software results, ETAP software and RCDC software, whether they are matching or not, how much percentage of difference will be there, okay, up to what percentage difference may come between that software. So that all discussion will be there. How you can match your ETAP result and RCDC result. Okay, so this will be included in this. So consultancy practicing with the ETAP software, consultancy practicing with the RCDC software, and consultancy for the designing of structural important structural elements, they are using the Excel. So that also we have included in this. So this is overall the second section of our training of dealing the real life project. So as you have seen here, we are not going to show you only the software, like commands of the software. Okay. So that is by default will come to you all the, because software we are also dealing in detail. Okay. There's no compromisation in the discussion of the software. Lot of things we are discussing here that will not be available anywhere in any other platforms. In a very detailed way, we are trying to cover the software also. All the settings of the software, all the commands of the software, all the basic import, export concepts, everything we are going to cover here. So this is the first section over, second section is over. Now in the third section, what you will learn in the third section? So all the advanced concepts we are going to cover in the third section, that will be what? Like we are going to deal high-rise structure. In the light of the CODEL recommendation by the IS 1893 2016 for the stability of the structure, IS 13920 for the ductile detailing of the structure, if your structure is subjected to the earthquake load and if your structure is more than of 50 meter, so the code is applicable to follow, code is needed to follow, that is 16700 2017. So what does the stiffness, ductility, strength, very interesting and very important topic. How you can, what is the role of designing the high-rise structure by making adequate stiffness, ductility, strength. Then earthquake loading, it's a calculation. Very excellent sheets we are having for the calculation of the earthquake load, for the calculation of the wind load. What are the different methods like static method, dynamic method, linear method, non-linear method. Okay. Every kind of things we are going to cover at advanced level. then modal analysis. What does the modal analysis? That will represent the shape of structure under the application of the loading. For example, if I am going to put a load over any structure, so it is going to be vibrate. It is going to be displaced from its position. So what's the codal recommendation? Okay, let me show you one example. Hello, you all are with me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, look at this.
Yes, sir.
This is the modal result. Modal result. So the code recommends that in the first mode and in the second mode, in the first mode and in the second mode, your model should not have any torsion. In the first mode, in the second mode, your model should not have any torsion. So look at this. This is the first mode. Mode first. So if you are looking over the result, so your first mode is having no torsion. It is only translational movement. It is only what? Only translational movement. See, it is not having any torsion. Okay, when you move to the second mode, see, now I am in the second mode. So look at this, I am at the second mode. So what is the behavior of the structure? So structure is having only translational movement. And in the third mode, the structure is having the torsion. In the third mode, this is having the torsion. So it's the correct behavior. Sometime after the analysis, what you will get? Your first mode. Sometimes what will happen, in the first mode, you are getting the torsion in your building, so that is wrong. In the second mode, you are getting the torsion in your building, that will be wrong. In the third mode, so the code recommends that if your structure should be free from torsion in the first mode, in the second mode. That is the correct behavior of the structure for the high rise. So how to achieve this thing? How to eliminate the torsion from your structure? So that is depends on the positioning of vertical elements like columns and shear wall. Columns and shear wall. So how to decide the position or orientation of the column such that your first mode and second mode should be free from torsion, that we are trying to cover in this training. And this is the most important check as suggested by the ISO 1893-2016. This will make your design as economical. It is little bit deep, you can't understand here right now. Okay, so it's okay. So that we are going to cover in this training program. Then P delta analysis. So what does mean the P delta analysis? How to perform the P delta analysis? What is the basic concept of P delta analysis? If you are performing the analysis, P delta analysis, what will be the change in your result? Concept of the meshing. What will happen if you are not assigning the meshing? What will happen if you are assigning the meshing to the structure? Load combination for the orthogonal, non-orthogonal building. Okay, overhead load time, load calculation, modeling of the retaining wall, structural stability check for the as per IS 1893-13920. These all things will be included here. And finally, we are going to complete this training with these all three sections. So we are going to deal high-rise structure also, and all the advanced topics we are going to cover in that. Okay, so finally, after completion of this training, what you will get? So daily live sessions will be there. In this training program, what? Daily live session like this. Here, I'm not giving much time to interact with you. I'm not making you able to ask me a question anytime. Why? Because due to time limitation, we have to complete it within a short period of time. But in real daily session, what will happen? You can ask me question anytime. This is an interaction. One side conversation will not be there. You can ask me question anytime. So daily live sessions will be there. Daily live session. Daily live interaction will be there 1.5 hour. Then that live session recordings will come to you next day. Okay. And all the practice material, all the PDFs, all the Excel sheets, all the CAD drawings, all everything will come to you. Second, third thing. Okay, and after completion of this training, exam will be there, and after that, you will be awarded with this certificate, with your obtained marks and grade. This kind of certified ISO certification will be provided from us. Okay, so this is all about the introduction of this training program. Is that all clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so the registration has been started. Okay, this is my number 885789-1345. This is my number and you have to pay the fee, 4,500, okay? And the training is going to be start. Registration has been started. You have, as much as possible, book your seat. If you have any question, doubt, you can ask.